Do you suffer from erectile dysfunction? Did you see a doctor for this? And did you get an ultrasound examination? If not, the reason for your erectile problem might still be undetected, because you can't always blame it on age. There are diseases of the penis which directly affect the erectile tissue and consequently result in erectile issues. I am talking about fibrotic changes of the corpora cavernosa of the penis. These changes are easily seen on ultrasound, but the problem is, if no sonography is performed, they will remain undetected. In this video, I will explain to you what fibrosis means and what is currently under development to revert fibrotic changes of the penis. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a urologist and sexologist. Subscribe to UroChannel now so that you won't miss out on new content, hit the Euro like button and activate the bell for notification of future uploads. The corpora of the penis are made of smooth muscle. This enables them to fill with blood when needed. The smooth muscle cells extend and the penis is elongating and erecting. Fibrosis means that smooth muscle undergoes a fundamental change. It is transformed into connective tissue. Connective tissue is no longer elastic. You could say it is the opposite of the tissue that was in place before. This process is driven by chronic inflammation. Inflammation triggers wound healing processes of the body. Under certain circumstances, wound healing doesn't stop and will go on forever. The result is what we call fibrosis. This is the ultrasound image of a penis with corporal fibrosis. You can easily see this dense area, which differs quite a lot from the surrounding tissue. This is a fibrotic area. It is obvious just by looking at it that corporal function has been lost, at least in this part of the penis. But for the penis to function properly, the corpora must work 100%, because otherwise they won't fill with blood entirely, and this means corporal pressure is partly reduced. Like on this picture after a cavernosal injection. If you want to know what injections are good for, watch this video. I added Doppler ultrasound to visualize blood flow, and as you can see, blood flow is absent where the fibrosis is. This is a big problem. For the blood to be trapped inside the organ, a certain pressure is needed against a firm structure called the tunica albuginea. This pressure is necessary to close off the veins of the penis, which are responsible for penile drainage. What then happens is what we call a venous leak. Blood enters the corpora and immediately leaves them again. The reasons for corpora cavernosa fibrosis include atherosclerosis, diabetes, and causes from outside, like a surgical procedure for prostate cancer. Corporal fibrosis is not as rare as one would think. Therefore, it is very important to perform an ultrasound for not to miss those. Now, how can this problem be solved? First of all, it is important to try to prevent fibrosis. This is predominantly done by a healthy lifestyle with regular physical exercise, including cardio and strength training, as well as adapting a more Mediterranean diet and abstaining from smoking. And diabetes has to be taken seriously. Apart from the fact that we increasingly enter into an inflammatory state the older we get, the metabolic syndrome is one of the main causes for diabetes. Therefore, try to avoid getting overweight or obese at any cost. Erections are important too. Without spontaneous erections or nighttime erections, the odds for penile fibrosis increase. How this works is the topic of another video I uploaded a while ago. However, once the damage has occurred, treatment gets difficult. So far, penile prosthesis is the only way to make the penis erect again, because neither Viagra nor injection therapy will be effective. But surgery gets difficult when there is fibrosis. A novel approach is stem cell injections, but this research is in the very early stages. At least in rats, some improvements were noted, but results from animal studies cannot be translated into humans. So stem cells might be an option when we will have data to suggest that it is effective. Also, platelet-rich plasma injections known as the P-shot are still regarded as experimental. If you want to know more about venous occlusive erectile dysfunction, watch this video. See you soon. Bye-bye.